Hello, I'm Luke Wright of Sussex Sharks in England. This is the NatWest T20 Blast Goes Old School. Today I'm going to be testing a whole range of bats from the last 120 years and comparing them with the modern ones today. I'm going to be seeing how far we can hit the ball. Let's get going. First up, we've got the Ranji bat. Oh, wow. Looks like one of Chris Nash's, to be honest. Looks pretty decent. A bit thinner than I'd probably like. Not too much shape, pretty straight, but we'll give it a go, see if I can get it off the square. But, yeah, first impressions, I think it's going to be pretty difficult, to be honest. Oh, a terrible shot for me to start with. Oh! Ranji, I think he's more known for the bit of the leg glance than the slog over cow. So yeah, we'll give it a crack. Oh, that's come out the middle. It's nearly six, that. Oh, that's gone miles. That's gone into the tennis court. There we go. The Ranji bat felt good actually. I liked it. Just it was light, obviously, but playing for T20, it was not too useful. I can definitely see you'd be more flips, and I can see why I invented the leg glance, because it's not really a bat you'd look to hit straight with. But it was nice to get one out the middle. But sadly, I can only give you a 2 out of 10. Next up, we've got the Wally Hammond, obviously absolute England legend. A little bit more wood in this one, actually, than the last one. Oh, that's gone nowhere. Obviously, as we're probably getting closer to modern-day bats, they were starting to get a bit thicker, but, again, very, very straight. No sort of curve on it that we have today. Oh, that's out the middle. Go on. Go on. This one's going to be OK, I think. If it was good enough for Wally Hammond, it's certainly going to be good enough, hopefully, for me. Oh, that's out the middle as well. Go on. That's got to go. Yes. 6. The Wally Hammond bat, it felt, yeah, obviously better than the Ranji bat. A little bit more forgiving, this one. Still a bat I'd definitely be probably using to flick the ball rather than hit sixes with. It's a bit like golf, though, isn't it? The better you are, the thinner the club you have, so shows how appalling we are.
He's such a legend. It's always hard comparing eras, but if he was brought up in this era with the talent he had, I'm sure he'd find a way. The bat was just too thin, slightly better than previous, but again, for me, I just wouldn't have been able to play T20 cricket with it. So I'm sad to say only a 3. Next up, we've got the David Gower bat, the actual legendary power spot. I remember seeing him always hitting the ball through backward point and gully. I've not really got that, and that's still nearly gone. We're going to be trying it off, obviously very different to how he played 2020. Oh, that's a horrible slog. Sorry, Gower. Power spot, obviously absolute iconic bat that we've all known since a young kid.
That's better.
That's near my car as well. Still very different to modern bats, but you can definitely see the change that was happening in that era. You can see why he was a timer of the ball and an elegance rather than trying to necessarily power hit. It's nothing to do with the bat, it's just the person using it now. Hard work, but I've had to go for a 6. Next up, we've got the Mark Ramprakash, the Predator. I think the shape's a lot more wood now coming into this. Remember buying at ramps on many occasions and him smacking me about.
Oh, that's gone mild.
Finally, we got one into the net. A lot more wood. Again, pretty straight bat, but a lot more closer to the shape that I use as a bat. So I think this one's going to be pretty good.
This is a lovely bat.
You know, if someone was using that in the change room, modern change room today, I don't think anyone would notice any difference. I think this is exactly how Ramps used to feel when he was facing me when I bowled. Obviously, he hasn't been retired long at all, and he played T20 cricket and was very successful at it. Now, I'd happily sort of walk out in a game tomorrow and go and bat with that bat. If I was using it in 2020 today, I'd be very happy. So I'm going to give him a 9. Right, now we move on to my own bat. Obviously spent time with the bat maker, going through the shape that's perfect for me.
Oh, that's a great start.
It's just taken a lot of pressure. Obviously like having big, thick edges, because I'm not always getting it out the middle. Having a slog, and especially in T20 when I've got my eyes closed at times, having a swing.
Keep picking out the cards here.
pressure's on. If I can't hit sixes with this bat, then I'm struggling for the season.
That's good enough.
Straight. Tell you what, whoever shaped this bat and chose this shape's a genius. Can't wait for the season. Being captain of the Sussex Sharks as well gives it added importance for me again. If that goes, I'm happy with that. Oh, it's always a great time of the year. I love playing in front of big crowds. We're very lucky with the support down here at Hove, and hopefully we can play some better cricket than we have done in the last few years. Managed to hit the most sixes with it, so that was pleasing, but obviously having a hand in designing the shape, but very happy with my bat maker, so going to give him the big 10.